Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Lisa, and in this video you'll see how I completed this frog and the branch and moss from start to finish. If you like this video, remember to like and subscribe for more tutorials to come in the future. So to complete this piece, I used Faber Castell Polychromos pencils and Fabriano Artistico hot press watercolor paper. In the description below, I'll put a list of the paper and pencils that I've used, including the colours and any other materials I've used as well. Let's get started drawing the frog. So I knew going into this piece that the hardest and most tedious bit of this would be the wood and the moss. So this is where I started, because I thought if I start with the frog and spend hours on that and then move on to the branch and the bark, which is not as exciting, by the end of it you sort of start to get over it and then start to rush it and it's not as effective. So I thought I will start with the branch and then move on to the frog at the end, which is the most exciting bit and brings it all to life. So starting with the branch, I broke it down into sort of little sections. So then I would spend a certain amount of time on each section. So starting to go in with the warm grey one and the ivory, depending which sections were sort of a creamy colour and which were more of a whiter grey colour. Then I start to build up the browns and the mid-tones, always referring to the reference photo to see where you can see all of those colors. So some of the mid-tones that I use are the light cadmium yellow, the beige red, also some blue colors like the cobalt blue, using the ivory sort of to blend, and the nougat to go into the sort of darker little nooks and crannies of the bark. Then when you get to the moss, started using sort of like the yellows and the greens, like the light green, grass green, and then going over with the darker colors like the raw umber, burnt sienna, nougat, Caput Morton violet, Van Dyke brown, and the dark sepia in the really, really dark areas to make more shadow. So some of the best advice that I can give to do texture like this is just to break it down into small sections and build your colors up lightly. So starting with the really lighter layers and then moving into the mid-tones and then going in with the darker colors to get all of the shadow and all of the outline, paying attention to your reference photo. It is important to understand that this sort of thing does take a long time, and if you go into sort of really big sections and start blending in all these colors, it does get very tedious and sort of you lose your place of where you are from your reference photo and your outline. So I found it really helpful to do smaller sections and break it down. So some of the colors that I did use in the moss is also the deep red and dark red and some of the orange glaze in the shadows, just because I knew that I was going to use that in the feet and the eyes of the frog, and you want it all to sort of come together as a cohesive piece. And if you just have all greens and browns in the branch and then all sort of really light greens and oranges in the frog, then it's not going to all come together and they'll sort of look too separate. So for the frog and under the skin, you'll see later that I did put some more greens and more of the colors that I put in the moss, but in the moss I've also put some of the colors that I've put in the frog as well. Also, to make the highlights stand out on each of the pieces of moss and bark, you can also go in with a white waxy pencil. So I use the Holbein soft white pencil just to go into the really light bits and really accentuate the shadow and the light hitting each of the branches and pieces of moss. And then in the darker areas, you can go in with the dark sepia, or I use the Van Dyke brown in this case to make the darker sections deeper. So then you use the white pencil to make the light sections pop, and you use the dark sections to accentuate the light bits. So moving on to the frog, I started with the left hand eye and went in with the light cadmium yellow and the nougat to outline the shape that I wanted of the actual eye, and then also the pupil. I then went in with the light cadmium yellow and put down a light base all over the whole eye, making sure not to go into the pupil and drag the darker color out of the pupil into the yellow section. I then went in with the cadmium orange and did another light layer, and then used the ivory pencil just to blend it down and make a smooth surface to work on. I then went in again with the cadmium orange and started to build up the darker colors that I could see, making sure to go around the highlight sections and not go into them. And then I also used the deep red and then the darker red to get the darker sections of the eye mapped out. Then it's just a case of looking at the reference photo and darkening up all the areas that you can see and lightening up the lighter sections with the Holbein soft white. And then you can start to go around the edges and get a little bit darker. And so on the right hand side of the eye, I could see that there was some cobalt green colors. So I started adding in some cobalt green and then layering over some dark red and deeper red. And putting these colors together gives you sort of like a dark gray color, which is perfect for the outside and what we needed for this one. So then I went in with the dark sepia very lightly over the pupil and started to layer in some red and green colors, which is the deep red and the cobalt green, and then going over darker with the dark sepia because I could see some blue and red tones in the pupil. And if you just go in with the dark sepia, it will sort of look flat and not as reflective as it should. Then when you have all of those dark colors in, you can start to see which sections of the eye need to get darker. So then now I've gone in with the cadmium orange, the orange glaze, the dark sepia, dark red and the deep red to get everything darker and start to make sure all the values are matching each other. So for this sort of section, you can go over many, many times and, you know, continue to build up the tones to get the color that you like. But you just need to make sure that you're sort of matching the same tone and darkness that you've already put down, so of the branch. Otherwise, if you do the eye too light, then the eye will look light against the darkness of the branch. So just making sure all the values are the same. So after the eye was completed, I started on the left-hand side and moved on to the foot of the frog. So I used the same sort of colors as I did in the eye on the frog. So I used the cadmium orange, the orange glaze, and the light cadmium yellow as a base. And then to darken that up, I went in with the deep red and the dark red and then started adding in a couple of the browner tones like the burnt sienna, bister, and Van Dyke brown to get them a bit darker. And for the green colors, I used the light green, grass green, and then went in with the same sort of darker colors. So using the darker reds are really good to get the color that you want in the shadows. So for the face of the frog, I'm not gonna lie, I really did struggle with this texture because there are so many sort of highlights in this face. It was really hard to get the values right and it did take a long time and a lot of blending. So then I sort of moved on to did a couple more toes and then moved back to the face to see how I was going. So I had a little bit of a break from it for a little while because it was getting very tedious and I didn't feel like it was working out. But remember, each piece goes through an ugly stage. So this is where we feel like it might not turn out very well, but then you just need to keep going and keep persisting. Put the darker colors in and then blending with the Holbein soft white really brought out the shadows and made it all come together in the end. So my favorite part of this whole piece is probably the skin under the neck, and it's just because it's so colorful and it's a really nice sort of purple rainbow tone. And to get this color, I didn't use any purple at all. Actually, I used the cobalt green and the deep red and the Holbein soft white just to blend them all together and get those shadows underneath. I used pretty much every color that I've used in this piece. So I used a little bit of green, the brown colors, the yellow tone as well. And then underneath the armpit, you can see a little bit of skin that sort of got like a dotty texture for his tummy. So I made sure to go in around those sections and then went in with the Holbein soft white to blend softly, go back in with the darker colors, and then put in the little spots with the Holbein soft white. Then as usual, after I completed it, I left it overnight and then came back to it the next day and added a couple more shadows and a few more little bits and pieces here and there just to finish it off with fresh eyes. So I really hope that this video has been helpful and you've learned something. Please give me a like and subscribe if you'd like to see more tutorials in the future. If you're working on something like this, remember to tag me on Instagram so I can see what you're working on, or let me know in the comments below, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks, bye. I just see her face wherever I look, she's standing in the crowd.